Hey everyone, I'm so excited today. We have Nilo Grabar here, a licensed paralegal. And the reason I'm so excited to be talking to him is because one of the most common questions we get from new landlords or new property investors is concerns over managing tenants and things like that. And I was just talking to Nilo. Nilo had this really good tip about just setting up the upfront expectations You're dealing with a tenant who moves into your rental property. So really quick, can you just give a quick little summary of what you were explaining? Was it a letter of direction?
Yeah, absolutely.
And why that's helpful?
Yeah, the most important thing to do and to know before having a tenant come in is to make sure that you back yourself up with proper documentation and you follow pretty much these simple steps. One is to always get an application and do your follow-up to find out whether or not these tenants are going to be good tenants for your rental property. Two is follow up with a lease. Make sure they sign a lease. Do not have them move
in. I'm assuming you see people move in without a lease before?
I've seen many a times. I mean, first and last, make sure you receive first and last payments.
Certified funds up front before you give the keys over.
Tenants. What you want to do is you want to have a final walkthrough with these tenants. And you have a checklist. Make sure you go through the entire property and get the tenants to initial to make sure that everything is as it should be. If there's any issues, they get addressed before the tenant moves in.
If you have that, can you go back to the tenant for damages? Well, it's still difficult, right?
Well, you know what? You have that as your own protection.
Yeah, okay.
If the tenant does say, well, you know what? I came in and there was all these other damages done, but it also helps you on a claim if the tenant does cause damages
to the rental unit,
stating the condition it was before they moved in. So that's something.
Andrea's arms are going to drop on us here. So let me get us to the letter of direction.
Letter of direction. Just as when the tenants move in, provide them a letter indicating, giving them instructions on what you'd like them to do, how you want them to make their payment, indicating that their payments are due on the first of each month, and also that any maintenance requests must be put in writing and give them direction as to where they
need to. I love that one the best because that takes away, if you ever go to the tenant board, if you've ever been to the tenant board, the tenant from being able to say, well, I mentioned these repairs needed to be done and they never got back to me. If you put up front that they need to be in writing, then at the tenant board, if you ever go there, the adjudicator would ask from the tenant to see those requests in writing.
I would be asking from the tenant.
Yeah, okay,
to see those.
Yeah. That's a really powerful one. That is a big tip.
It's just a way for the landlord to protect themselves.
Okay. Right? Okay, Nilo, thank you so much. If anyone wanted to reach out to you, what's the best way? At a website, phone number, can you share?
Yeah, www.affirmparalegal.com, or you could contact me direct at 905-388-2458.
And the URL again was www.affirmparalegal.com.
That's
perfect. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem.
Until next time, everyone, your life, your terms.